Here I'm with James from Print and Play. He has been doing some crazy projects for this event. He had created an arcade and a printer. So, James, what can you tell us about the arcade and what was the most challenging part of doing it?
Well, my original arcade was this guy here. This one's a 7-inch screen, and really the most complicated part was trying to design it so that the parts would print as few parts as possible and require as little support material as possible. And I displayed this one back at MRF, and after that IC3D was in conversation with me about sponsoring some projects, and I decided to print this bad boy here, which is super similar to the single player one, but offers two controls and a 16-inch screen. And really, the software ended up being a bigger challenge than the modeling. Modeling this one compared to that one was super simple because the you've got so much extra space to work with. I mean, the inside of it's half empty, so. The most challenging thing in terms of the smaller ones is the part placement, but with the big one, was mostly software.
Yeah. Yeah. Then you did your own 3D printed printer. Your own design.
Yeah. This is my design 3D printable 3D printer. It's not quite RepRap. It prints on the CR10 or a like size 300x300 bed. I really wanted to see how far I could get with 3D printing stuff. So I use 3D printed bushings for the X and the Z. And the frame prints as one solid piece up to the edge of the blue here. This fits diagonally on the CR10, so you can print it as the second piece. And the base is optional, but it allows you to hide all the electronics and everything underneath it. And the entire thing is carryable from the top.
That's cool.
It delivers a build volume of 195 on the X by 185 on the Y by 220 on the Z. So it's a pretty decent build volume.
Yeah, and you made the design in Fusion 360?
Yeah, it was all involved in Fusion 360, and luckily all the parts fit together. It was like a moment of truth, but it works pretty well.
And are you planning to do a build guide with bill of materials and STL files so that all the people can...
Yeah, exactly. So as I did the build, I recorded as much content about it as I could. And I'm going to put it together in a tutorial series, and then once the tutorial series is done, I will release the STLs and everything on Thingiverse, and people can have fun with it, do whatever they want to do with it.
Yeah, that's cool.
Thanks.
Yeah, awesome. Thanks for this.
Thank you.
Yeah.